Honda Formula Dreams project, that is obviously a driver's development program, comes from Honda. They just focused on that time for Super Formula and Super GT. And after that, when they announced when they're gonna work together with McLaren again, they sent out some drivers to Europe to compete and could be the next Takuma Sato or Yuji Ide. In the end, there's one driver that managed to get out and race in Formula 1, especially this season. I'm not gonna tell you the drivers because you already know. But how about the other drivers who raced in Europe? I'm gonna rank all of these 9 drivers who's come from 9 to 1st, who's the unlucky one who should deserve that Formula 1 seat before that guy. I'm RTH Feeder, so don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and turn on the notification below, and follow my Instagram and Twitter, alright, at RTH Feeder. Let's go into it. First up is number 9, and that is Toshiki Oyu. In 2016, he managed to get 3rd in Formula 4 Japanese Championship. But he stayed in Japan till now, to be honest, and he never raced in Europe until in 2019, where he comes to replace Yuki Tsunoda for one round, and that's in Silverstone. Because Yuki Tsunoda raced in Formula 3 and obviously focused on that series rather than your Formula. And at that time in 2019, where in Monza, Yuki Tsunoda won the race and Toshiki Oyu won the race as well. But not just for one, two races. Coming from two pole position and he managed to ace up a win. That's a great substitute, to be honest. And in the end, he come back to Japan and he raced in Super Formula with Nakajima Racing. That is the equivalent to ART of Super Formula mostly. And in my opinion, he should be in European racing way beforehand. But to be honest, I don't know why Honda planned up he raced in Japan mostly. But some of people touted him as the next Satoru Nakajima. And the next driver is number 8. Takuya Izawa. When Honda already announced in 2013 that they're gonna have McLaren as their team, they're gonna thought who's the next driver to fill up and gonna be the test and reserve driver in the future of 2015. They come up to Takuya Izawa. I don't know why they don't recruit Naoki Yamamoto. I don't know why. But in the end, they choose him. At the raw age of 29 to 30 years old at that time in 2014. His previous record in Super Formula and Super GT is not that particularly well, to be honest. But in the end, he joined up the best team in GP2, and that is ART. Teammates of Stoffel Vandoorne. Oh, poor him. Even though Stoffel Vandoorne managed to get runners-up in his first season, Takuya Izawa only managed to get one podium in the end, even though it's just from driver's penalty at the time. But in the end, he only collect some points, but it's not good enough because he only managed to get 18 in the standings. And in the end, Honda regret that they rather choose young-blooded drivers rather than oldies, to be honest. Coming up in number 7, and there is Teppei Nattori. In 2018, he managed to get runners-up in Japanese Formula 4, losing out to the Alpha Mansion Yuki Tsunoda. He gonna follow Yuki Tsunoda to the same series, and that is Formula 3 and Euro Formula as well. But the difference is, he's joined up to Carlin Racing in both series. But obviously his focus is Formula 3. But in that series, he failed miserably. He only managed to get 1 point and 24th in the standings. But in Euro Formula Open, he managed to get 1 win, 2 pole position, 1 fast lap, 3 podiums, and 6th place. His European journey obviously over because the result itself is bad. They don't want to consider Euro Formula as well because it's a crap series, obviously. It's not that particularly competitive as well. And in 2020, he joined up in Super Formula Lights, managed to get 4th, and now, sadly for him, Honda dropped him. He doesn't have any backings anymore, and he crowdfunding right now. Coming up in number 6, and that is Ren Sato. He's not related to Takuma Sato, not to Kimiya Sato, or even Makino Sato. Obviously, because the name itself is very common in Japan. So before he comes to Europe, he already managed to get first place in Formula 4 Japan in 2019. And he raced in French Formula 4 Championship last season. And sadly for him, he gotta lose to that other Japanese driver. He only managed to get 4 wins, 2 pole positions, 6 fastest laps, and 12 podiums. In the end, he only managed to get runners-up, and sadly for him, because Japanese teammates won, he have to go back to Japan, where he have to race in Super Formula Lights and also Super GT in 300 class. That's very awful for him. If Honda still racing towards 2025, maybe Ren Sato could have another chance and race in Formula 3 or even in other series like Formula Regional. But we never know, to be honest. And coming up in number 5, and that is Ayumu Iwasa, the Alpha Mansion driver who beats Ren Sato to the title in last season's French Formula 4. He managed to get 9 wins, 7 fast laps, 5 pole positions, 15 podiums, and thus he's the champion of French Formula 4. If you win the French Formula 4, you obviously get Renault Sports Academy automatically for the next season. But obviously, he's still affiliated with Honda's, thus he cannot. No worries. After Yuki Tsunoda promoted to Formula 1, he got himself the backup of Red Bull Racing. And that is Red Bull Junior Team, duh. And he raced in Formula 3 Asia in the Winter Series and also Formula 3 with Hi-Tech, both of the series anyway. But in Formula 3 Asia already finished, he only managed to get 1 podium, but sadly for him, that podium is come from the driver's penalty in the end, and he only managed to get 8 in the standings. Not to worry, our expectation for him is not gonna be like Yuki Tsunoda of top 3. He's gonna learn, to be honest, if Red Bull and Honda has the patience of it, obviously. But let's see how it goes anyway, right? And coming in number 4, and that is Daisuke Makino. His European venture is a little bit shaky, to be honest. Where he started Formula 3 Championship, because in previous season, he competes in Japanese Formula 4 and managed to get 5th overall. He competes with Hi-Tech Grand Prix, and his teammates are Ralph Aaron, Jake Hughes, and I don't want to mention his name, Nikita Mazepin. Only managed to get 1 podium and 15 in the standings. The result-wise, he should go back to Japan and compete again in Super GT or Super Formula. In the end, Honda still trusts that he has that talent and competes in Formula 2 racing in Russian time. That's a war shock, to be honest, because I didn't expect him to race in Russian time at the time. Ooh. He managed to get 1 win, and that's in Monza, but in the end, that's all. The problem for him is just inconsistency. That's all. He can race better in the next season in Formula 2, but in the end, he didn't continue. He managed to get 13 in the standings, so he have to go back to Japan, race in Super GT and Super Formula with the same team, Kojima Racing, the Alpha Mansion of ART of Japan. He managed to get first place in Super GT in last season. In Super Formula, he didn't do well, obviously. Sadly for him, on the last round, he suffered from meningitis. Till now, he's still in recovery, and I hope him do well. We wish him get well soon enough. And coming up in number 3, and that is Nirei Fukuzumi. Fukuzumi shows some glimpses and shows some potential. His first year in GP3, he managed to get 3 podiums and 7th place. It's not bad. But his second year, it's almost avant-garde, when he get 2 wins, 2 pole positions, 6 podiums, and 3rd in the standings, only far off with Jet Aitken and the winner of the series, George Russell. Thus, obviously promotion is good, but sadly he joined the wrong team, and that is in decline, Arden. Especially with that pink car, and Fukuzumi upgraded to Red Bull Junior Team. Red Bull colors and BWT never match, I don't know why. But in the end, he struggled, to be honest. I pity for him because he didn't get anything. He lose out to Teppei Makino just by many points and obviously a win and podium. In the end, he managed to get 17 points and 17 in the standings. Sadly for him, he didn't get any second chance. Red Bull dropped him, but Honda support him and he puts back in Super Formula and Super GT. Good thing is, he is the champion in Super GT 300 class. But in the end, his focus is also Super Formula, and I expect him to be the champion in the near future of 2-3 years, and if he can get a decent team, obviously team down the line is almost like them, I expect him next 2 years be the champion. My unpopular take on is, he's the better driver than Yuki Tsunoda. He's the unfortunate one who gets bad car, to be honest. And he should be in Formula 1 if he get the right car in Formula 2 2019. But it is what it is, and we don't know anything, right? And coming up next in runners up, and that is Nobuharu Matsushita. Before his European venture, he managed to get first place in Japanese Formula 3. That's good. And in 2015, he joins up ART, teams up with Stoffel Vandoorne, and replacing the Alpha mentioned before, Takuya Izawa. And I forgot to mention before, ART and McLaren and Honda working together, thus, technically, they are the McLaren B team. Nobuharu Matsushita didn't get the second car seat yet. He only managed to get 1 win, 1 fast lap, 3 podiums, and overall 9 in the standings. That's not bad. But in his second year, where he team up with Sergei Sirotkin, while Nobuharu Matsushita gets 11th in the standings. Same, he gets 1 win, but 4 fastest lap and 2 podiums. But Honda has the same fate to him, give him another season. He managed to get 2 wins, 2 fast laps, 4 podiums, and 6 overall. Honda deemed him not good enough for Europe, thus he going back to Super Formula. But Super Formula itself, he only managed to get 11th in the standings. Poor him. But in 2019, Honda gave him another chance. And that is raced with Carlin in Formula 2. And he managed to get 6 again in the standings with 2 wins, 1 pole position, 4 past lap, and 5 podiums. But in the end, Honda want to throw him back to Super GT and Super Formula, but Nobuharu said no. He stayed with the series and competes with MP Motorsport. But unlucky for him, even though he got that 1 win, it's underperformed for him. But this season, he links up with Super GT and not gonna race in Super Formula. He's back up with Nissan right now, so not bad for him, to be honest. Obviously, the number one on this list, and that is Yuki Tsunoda. I don't need to highlight it up too much because other Formula 1 YouTube content creators do the same. Highlight it up Yuki Tsunoda every time and the history as well. And I just going up quickly, brief, that is. And 2018, he managed to get first place in Japanese Formula 4. Then he going up to Europe, managed to get 10th in Formula 3 with Jensen Motorsport from all teams, and 3rd overall in Euro Formula Open with Motorpark. Then he leaps up to Formula 2 with Carlin, and we didn't expect him to be in top 10 as well because people thought he's gonna be like Nero Fukuzumi, but no, he proved us wrong. He managed to get top 3, and that is 3rd place, and look where he is now, and that is in Formula 1 with AlphaTauri. Can he do better this year? We don't know. Let's find out this Sunday. Hopefully, he's gonna do well. That's all. It has been my video. Comment below if you think I'm right or your opinions about Nere Fukuzumi or other drivers that should be in Formula 1 rather than Yuki Tsunoda or given another chance. But we don't know. So comment below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe again. It has been your boy. And see you on the next video.